Senator, I want to talk about the election that just happened. You endorsed Donald Trump over Hillary Clinton, but it wasn't that long ago you were running against Mr. Trump for the GOP nomination, and you called him unfit for the presidency. Take a listen.
We're about to turn over the conservative movement to a person that has no ideas of any substance on the important issues, the nuclear codes of the United States, to an erratic individual.
Senator, do you still have those concerns about President-elect Trump?
Well, Dana, the bottom line, we had an election, and ultimately the voters chose him, both as our nominee and now as our president. So the election is over, and now it comes time to govern, and we're going to give him every chance to be successful. And that's what I'm focused on now. At some point, elections end, and the governing needs to begin. So we'll have another election for Congress in 2 years, and another election for president in 4. But right now, my hope is that this president is given the opportunity, this president-elect is given the opportunity to be successful. And that's been a long tradition in this country. When the election ends, you don't root against the president-elect because you understand that while you'll have significant policy disagreements with them, whether they're in your party or not, if they don't succeed, the country gets hurt. So I'm going to give him every opportunity to be successful. He has earned this position. He was elected to this position, and he deserves the opportunity to be successful.
Senator, I completely get that elections are over and now it is time for governing. But given the fact that it is time for governing and your criticism was about his abilities to govern, even as far as saying that he shouldn't have have the nuclear codes because he's too erratic, what will you do as senator, as somebody who actually has the responsibility of check and balance to make sure that he is governing properly, given the concerns that you expressed?
The same as I would do with anybody else who's elected. I mean, we have a role in the Senate, for example, in cabinet appointments and nominations, that we'll review each of those, and we'll play our proper role under the Constitution. We'll do the same with public policy. If I would agree with him on a public policy, I'll work with them on it. If I disagree with them, I'll oppose it. And that's the job of the Senate, not to be a rubber stamp. But that doesn't mean we open this broadcast here today by attacking the person or our differences. There's no doubt that during the campaign, I wanted to be the president of the United States. The voters chose differently, both in the Republican primary and ultimately in the general election. So the campaign ends, and now he should be given the opportunity to be successful. And again, if I agree with him on something, I'm going to be a supporter and work hard to achieve it. And if I disagree with him on a policy matter, then I'll come on this show and others, and I'll talk about why I believe that's the wrong way forward and offer an alternative.
So do you feel comfortable now with Donald Trump in charge of the nuclear arsenal?
I feel comfortable that the voters have chosen him to be the commander-in-chief, and we're going to give him every chance to be a successful one. And ultimately, it'll be incumbent upon him, as it would be upon any president who is elected, but to prove their capability in that role. And he deserves that opportunity. He has earned it at the ballot box.